Welcome to Shorty Supercoach, and today Shorty's going to have a rant. It's pre-season time again, and as always, there's so many supercoaches out there who are so flimsy and trigger happy with their sides, it's unbelievable and it does my head in. It's NAB Challenge, alright, it's got a title, alright, it's televised, you can listen on the radio, you look up the stats, but they're glorified practice matches, that's all it is. Teams have played practice matches for years and years. You used to just look at the scores in the paper, see who was in the best. It wasn't as glorified as it is today, but now that NAB Cup is gone, footy gets some good coverage. It's great to see. It's good to watch it, and I enjoy it. But people take it as way too much than it actually is. You see so many people look at one player, and he has a poorish sort of NAB challenge. 1 week, mind you. Kicks out of their side, he's done. I've made one change to my team since NAB Challenge has been over. Don't get me wrong, I've got about five guys who I've got, you know, question mark next to that I'm watching really closely. But I haven't shuffled it around, switched it around on the simple basis of he was quiet in a NAB challenge game. Teams have different ultimatums for each game and each player. Some players just want to get minutes through their legs. Others want to set the world on fire for round one. Others just want to play in a different position to, you know, work out that experience and where they might be playing in the season. But for more often than not, and especially our premium players, which I've stressed don't take too much into account with NAB Challenge results for the premiums, most just want to get minutes into their legs, run out three quarters or whatever, get the feel, get into it. They'll rest throughout certain periods of the game and probably take weeks off as well. But don't let it affect what you're really lining up for your round one side and Supercoach. NAB Challenge is all about the youngsters and who's going to really lock up that rookie spot for us. Matt Lobe has been the exact example of what I'm talking about. Don't get me wrong, I was far from impressed what he produced against Max Gawn. Yeah, he was smashed. He was hammered. Apparently, he looked slow. He didn't look that great. His stats don't read awfully. They're not great stats. He was well beaten. Well beaten by one of the most improving and dominant ruckmen on the way up in the comp. So, spare him a bit of time, you know. Lobe has exited so many people's sides, and I'm reading this thread and that thread about, oh geez, do I pick Goldie now? I need a set and forget play. Oh geez, his Blitzars, where's he going to play? Just calm your farm, seriously. I mean, Lobe may well exit my team in 2 weeks as well, but I'm going to give him a couple of games to see what he can produce, see how he plays, get rolling into it. It's one game, it wasn't his finest. He came up against a player who's coming into their peak, really. He dominated Gawn, which was impressive for any owner that's looking at him. But don't just shoot the trigger, pull the trigger and just go bang, Lobe, you are done, mate. Because I reckon he still offers great value. He's going to be the sole ruck. Is he going to be a top five ruck? It's probably doubtful, but he's got cash to make you there. And as far as I'm concerned, still, he is the perfect man to lock in early. He rises in price. Goldstein will inevitably drop. How much? I'm not too sure, but he will drop in price. Easy swap. That's all I'm concerned about at this point in time. Yeah, he didn't set the world on fire, but just calm down. So many people pulling the trigger, going crazy about their teams off 1 week of NAB Challenge, and then they play a second game and they're not that impressed. Just look back at the NAB Challenge as a whole. That's what I'm doing, because we've got plenty of time. There's no need to have your team submitted tomorrow. It's all G, you know. I'll be looking very closely at Toby Green tonight, how much midfield time he's getting. I'm concerned about him, yes, because there's a wealth of midfielders for the Giants. But am I kicking him out of his side if he doesn't play and have 30 touches tonight? No, I'll watch the game, I'll see how he goes. But just look what NAB Challenge brings over the course of three games. Look at their stats as a whole, their contested ball ratings, clearances, everything like that. All those key indicators for the position that you want them to be in, and then make a call. But I can't stress enough how many people I see just going all out off one NAB Challenge game. It's unbelievable, and it does my head in. So just calm down. I've only made one change since NAB Challenge has started. That was in my back line. It was Brody Smith, because I could see at the moment he is not looking like he's going to play midfield time. You know what? If that changes, well, he's back on my radar. But people got to stop putting lines through people off three quarters of a glorified practice match and just settle down. So give me your thoughts on that sort of topic. Are people pulling the trigger way too quick? If you ask me, absolutely. But give the video a like. There'll be another NAB Challenge review after the weekend, hopefully Tuesday, I think. And as always, subscribe to the channel, because I'll be churning out plenty of Supercoach content in the near future.